A few words about our setup. Here is our propagation area. It's actually growing room, Chris is calling this, because at the end of that we have another little room that it's a germination area. You can see right there at the bottom, it's another room inside this one, because here it's inside the glass house. We separated a part of the glass house, so we'll make this into a growing room because we need to heat it and the plants need a lot of warmth, and that's why we can't do whole the glass house, can't heat all of this glass house. So that's why we're just heating a little bit of a part of it to get the plants growing. Then as they grow, the time will pass on, the temperature will raise up outside as well, so we can come in the other part of the glass house as well. So in here we have growing quite a few different type of plants. We've got a heater in here that we took the chimney out the window. We've got a tank for watering because the plants need warm water at the start. Otherwise, you can affect their growth if you water them with cold water. So we've got some growing lights in here as well, which on a rainy, cloudy day, we switch them on, and sometimes some hours at night as well. Here it's some more seeds and plants that are growing. Of course, the tomatoes already reached 1 meter in high, some of them, and they need to go out. We can't hold them in here anymore because they're competing for light, and that could be bad for them. So now we are in our propagation room. Here we have a lot of plants growing, a lot of seedlings going on, planting more and more every week. Each week has a batch that we have to sow, otherwise we mid-season we would run out of a certain crop. But if we're gonna sow it like in batches each week, then we've got a continuity. So I've got here some chilies, lettuce and other things that are doing very well in the germination room. You can see even my miniature banana plants was down there. Here I've got some kohlrabi and fennel, which again we're sowing them every week. It's very important because once you cut it one time, for example kohlrabi or lettuce or other things that you, once you cut, they don't grow again, like the tomatoes for example. Once you picked, they will have other tomatoes come on and you can continue picking all year. But with the lettuce, kohlrabi, even garlic, here is a garlic that is in a cold part of the glass house. And once you picked it, you need to replant it again, the same as lettuce and other things. So it's a continuity all the time. We already laid the grow bags here in this part of the glass house where the plants, the tomato plants, are going to come. We have some heaters in here because it's very important not to have a cold. They've been nourished and they've been looked after and they've been cozy in that part, in that growing area we made, and now all of a sudden they go in the cold. No, we can't do that to them. We're too kind to our tomato plants. So we put some heating, we done some plastic on the sides, we isolated this area again. It's a bigger part of the glass house, so we put it some plastic to isolate it from the other part that will not gonna be heated.
so the plants will be cozy. We burn the heaters at night because it's colder, colder time, colder part of the 24 hours, of course. But in the daytime, when a little bit of sun is coming out in this area, we actually have to lift the plastic up. We have to open up the windows even, because it's getting very, very hot. It's up to 44. We had 44 degrees in there when we've been a little bit late one day to open the windows. Was up to 44 degrees, so the plants don't like that. So we need to keep an eye on the temperature and on the growth, on the watering and everything. We're still gonna water with warm water, I mean with room temperature water, which is here in the glasshouse. You see the container where we've got a good amount of water, so it gets time to warm up, and then the plants will get that water. Here you can see how we're getting them out from the growing part of the glasshouse, from the growing room. We call this growing room, as I said from the start. So the plants are quite big already. We bring them out with the gutters, because we lay them in the gutters, and that's easier than to get them out, not disturbing them too much, taking them out one by one. We take a gutter full of, I think it's 30 odd plants on the gutter, and they go in the other part of the glass house. So that's the process. It's not that bad, actually. It's very nice to see how everything is growing. The tomato plants already have, some of them have up to 5 trusses. So it's not far away until we start picking. I'm gonna be very excited about that. But still a lot of work, still needs to support them, we need to put them on the strings, and we need to take the shoots off, because they will take the power away from the plant, so we can't allow that. Here you can see, I've been talking about that you have to shake your tomatoes. If you don't have the bees to do the pollination, then you have to shake the tomatoes. Here, sometimes when you do that in the daytime, you can't really see how the pollen actually comes out from the flower. But we done this in the night, just pointing a torch at the flower, and you can see how the pollen comes out from the flower. It's very nice. If you like this sort of thing, it's very intriguing. I loved it. Look at that. All the pollen comes out. When you're doing in daytime, sometimes you're thinking, oh, it's not helping anything, but it's actually, it is helping.
To the roof.
Look at our cucumbers. They're so big now. We already have a nice taste of the cucumbers, the miniature cucumbers, gherkins we're calling them. They're quite big.
Hey, look, that was.
Yeah, they love.
And Chris is very, very proud of them as well. We put them up this year, so they are gonna kind of shade it a little bit in this growing room, because it gets very, very hot in there. This is our tomatoes. We already have little green tomatoes, so it's not far away. It's a matter of few weeks from picking, and it's March now. It's still March. Very nice. Very proud of that. Have a look at them, little beauties. Look how they're hanging up like grapes at the moment. Very nice, very nice. To have tomatoes nearly end of April, we're thinking maybe even earlier, some of them.
Potatoes are coming through. Here you go.
Yes, I got here one as well.
Yes.
So how many days from sowing are these cucumbers?
6th of January and we're now 9th of
March.
March, so it's 9 weeks.
9 weeks. So they were already producing. We had the first cucumbers the other day. Girls enjoyed it very much. So that's good. I see some little tomatoes on our tomatoes as well.
Yeah, it's around the corner.
Yes.
The other. Let me go and fetch.
Yes. I've got another batch. This is the small ones that coming later. But the big tomatoes, they were ready. Look at that. Look at these tomatoes. Oh, wow. Already have the green tomatoes. Look at that truss. Oh, my, my.
No, just leave them alone.
Yes.
You'll probably break it off.
Yeah.
If it's fairly... So it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 trusses in flower.
Yes. Oh, wow. 5 trusses in flower.
Yeah.
9 of March, and we already have 5 trusses in flower and little tomatoes on our plant, which is great.
This is Emily's plant.
This is Emily's plant. She planted it in the pot. Wow.
This is Emily's plant, and we will make it that she'll have this and she'll
pick her own.
Yeah.
Yes.
It'll be her plant.
Mommy, yeah. Can you
see your plant? Can you see your plant? With the tomatoes.
Mommy, can Jessica
come to farm? No, I don't think her parents will let her. You can play in the nursery with Jessica, but not on the farm. Sorry.
Can I go Jessica's plant too?
You want a hug?
Yeah.
Give mommy a hug. Oh, another hug. Do you want a hug as well? Little sunshine. Come on. Okay. Tea break! Are we having a tea break?
Francesca? Kashka?
Francesca!
Where's mommy?
Cheese! Cheese! Yes! Come on,
she's helping me load up. She's helping me. Come on in. Push, push, push.
Push, push, push. Oh, wow! Good girl! She's helping daddy.
Yes, she's helping daddy. Come watch down here. Push.
Mommy, can you send me pictures to Sam?
Yay! You had enough, Francesca, of helping?
You see these beans?